Today's Earth Day. Are you excited? I'm excited. Everybody loves Earth Day. Come on. Earth Day. It's the best. What's there not to love about Earth Day? I mean, a holiday that was created by a person who composted his girlfriend. I mean, that is a dude who took Earth Day super seriously. True story. The guy who started Earth Day killed his girlfriend and put her in a trunk in his closet where she proceeded to drip into the bottom apartment, which is how she was originally. But Earth Day is great. Earth Day. Listen, we all appreciate our environment, particularly when it's trying to kill us. I will say that my original take on nature has stood up pretty well over time, which is nature is trying to murder you. And basically, all of human life is about trying to avoid nature murdering you. The reason that I bring this up is because this morning, I'm starting to see the pagan awakening of some members of the radical left, many members of the radical left, suggesting that this is nature's revenge, nature's revenge. Now, I have been informed by reliable sources that nature does not actually have intent. And I've been informed by reliable sources on the left that God doesn't exist, number one. And then even if God did exist, nature does not have intent, right? I mean, evolutionary biology suggests that basically it's survival of the fittest out there, that nature is trying to kill you, and that those who survive, survive. So the idea that nature is having her revenge because we were mean to nature, and now Mother Nature is coming out and just blasting us. Mother Nature has decided to release a virus, unleash a plague upon us. Pretty pagan crap. And frankly, I'm a bit upset with the Pope for pushing it. So Pope Francis actually pushed this nonsense yesterday, or today, rather. He made an impassioned plea, according to Reuters, for protection of the environment on Wednesday's 50th anniversary of the first Earth Day, which, again, is a pagan holiday. Environmentalism has become a religion for a lot of folks, and complete with activities like we have to separate our recycling and our trash, even though most of the time the recycling goes to the same place as the trash does, namely to the dump, or that it is more expensive in many cases to recycle than it is to throw things in the garbage. I've talked about articles in the past that actually detail the cost breakdown to the environment, by the way, in the entire recycling movement. Recycling does some good things. It also does some things that are pretty not great for the environment, including some fairly significant carbon emissions, depending on how you process all of that. But it's become sort of a ritualistic thing for a lot of environmentalists to talk about the environment as though it has its own level of brute force intent, which, of course, it does not. And the fact that the Pope is buying into it is pretty amazing. Francis praised the environmental movement, saying it was necessary for young people to, quote, take it to the streets to teach us what is obvious. That is, there will be no future for us if we destroy the environment that sustains us. Now, listen, I'm all in favor of protecting the environment from predations. I'm all in favor of environmental regulations that prevent externalities, prevent you from polluting a river that I'm going to use, prevent you from just willy-nilly chopping down forests for no apparent reason. All those regulations are good. Right? Otherwise, you end up with the so-called tragedy of the commons. But the Pope's moral language here with regard to the environment itself is quite bizarre. He recounted a Spanish proverb that God always forgives, man sometimes forgives, but nature never forgives. Well, nature doesn't forgive because nature does not have the power to forgive. If you're looking for some sort of thing that you can do that will make nature nicer to you, good luck with that. Good luck with that. Most of human history was marked by privation and danger, thanks to the environment. And it is only technology that has allowed us to surpass that. We've forgotten about that because we live in an industrialized society. We've forgotten about the fact that danger is just an inherent part of life and that nature is a very, very dangerous place. One of the reasons that you live in comfort is because of technology designed against nature. I'm not a big camping. I know a lot of people love camping. I'm not a big camping person because civilization was basically designed to avoid camping. That's it. That's what civilization was designed to do. So you have a permanent roof over your head. And I understand getting out there and enjoying nature. Really, I get it. You know, I want to take my walk every day. I want to go out and go for a hike with my kids. But this bizarre idea that nature is taking revenge on us and that this is a punishment for global warming or some such is really quite insane. And we are starting to see sort of inklings of that on the left, an almost quasi-celebration. It started off a few weeks ago in what they call the deep green movement. People who are celebrating, look at the cities going back to the animals, the cities being overrun by nature again. Look how clear the sky is over Los Angeles. We'll get in a second to the left's take on global warming, because the radical left, and it's not the entire left, right? Most people on the left want to get back to work. Most people who are liberals want to get back to work, and they are not into the whole, what if we just shut down all of human civilization? Isn't this great? But I'll show you in a second how this is starting to cross streams with some of the environmental movement. And like Pope Francis said, we see these natural tragedies, which are the Earth's response to our maltreatment. What? like the earth doesn't have its own paganistic capacity. He said, I think if I ask the Lord now what he thinks about this, I don't think he would say it's a very good thing. It is we who have ruined the work of God. I mean, right now, I'm fairly certain it is the environment that is responsible for, you know, hundreds of thousands of deaths around the world, tens of millions of people out of work. The earth's response to our, the earth did not respond. The earth is not alive. He says, we have sinned against the earth, against our neighbor, and in the end, against the creator. You can sin against your neighbor and you can sin against the creator. And you can say that failure to protect the environment is a sin against the creator. I don't know how you sin against an inanimate object. I don't know how it's possible to do that. So this sort of coming from the Pope, it's pagan nonsense. I'm kind of shocked that he said all of this, except that he had talked about the notion of environmental sin before. So I find it puzzling. That's all I will say about that. However, this does cross streams, as I say, with other parts of the environmentalist movement. As I mentioned, you know, sort of last note on the environmentalist movement that is using this pandemic as sort of a bizarre pagan belief system in which, because we drove cars, now nature has taken her revenge by killing 85-year-olds. Like that is how nature has gone about doing this. One aspect of this is the green movement's focus on global warming. So Eric Holthaus, who is just a very, very clever fellow, apparently, he writes on climate at the Cores. He calls himself an eco-socialist, and he wrote this. So CBC News put out this notice. The coronavirus pandemic is expected to drive down carbon dioxide emissions by 6% this year, the World Meteorological Organization says. It would be the biggest annual drop since World War II. And Eric Holthaus wrote this. This is roughly the same pace the IPCC says we need to sustain every year until 2030 to be on pace to limit global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius and hit the Paris climate goals. This is what rapid, far-reaching, and unprecedented changes in all aspects of society looks like. We're doing it. It's possible. We need to take some serious time and energy during this pandemic to look around and see what parts of this new way of living we can keep, like less air travel, and what parts we can't, like huge unemployment. There is a balance. We'll find it. That's the whole point of a Green New Deal. We need a just transition for workers and those who have been marginalized by the excesses of the capitalist system that got us into this mess. We can build a better world for everyone out of the ashes of the old one. And all I can think of here is that Monty Python sketch with Jesus on the cross singing "Always Look on the Bright Side of Life." Like, that's all I can think of here. In the middle of a global pandemic, it's killing hundreds of thousands of people and tens of millions of people are out of work and can't feed their families. And Eric Holthaus is like, yes, but we can do this indefinitely. And we can bring down the climate by 1.5 degrees Celsius over the next 100 years if we just keep this up for like the next decade. If we just figure out how to do this for like the next decade. Okay, sure. And these are the people who supposedly are deeply concerned about humanity and our future. Mm-hmm. Great. Did you know that every like on this video creates one additional leftist tier? Don't ask me why. That's called science. To take advantage of this amazing opportunity, hit the like button.